love between a superstar and a maths teacher really work, especially if they're strangers? Well, that's the question posed in Marry Me, the brand-new romantic comedy starring Jennifer Lopez, Owen Wilson and Colombian singer-songwriter Maluma. I caught up with the trio ahead of the film's release in cinemas tomorrow.
In 36 hours, superstar Kat Valdez and Grammy-winning Bastion will perform their new song, Marry Me, and exchange vows in front of a streaming audience of 20 million people.
See you tomorrow. Tonight, tonight, tonight.
I'll be the one in the veil. What's everybody looking at?
Nothing. Give me your phone.
Kat Valdez's husband-to-be, Bastion, caught cheating with her assistant.
Hold this.
I'm told that 20 million people are supposed to watch as we take our vows.
They say if you want something different, you have to do something different.
Why not?
Yes. I'll marry you. You.
Go!
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 Do you, some guy, take Kat to be your lawfully wedded wife?
Okay.
Hey, Owen, I think what a lot of fans love watching this is the idea that an ordinary person could end up with one of the most famous people in the world. Do you think that can really work in real life?
Yeah, I think it can. I mean, I think, you know, certainly part of going to the movies and, you know, a story like this is that kind of wish fulfillment. But I feel like I remember as a kid, like, Elizabeth Taylor kind of marrying some guy that wasn't in the public eye at all. And I do think that Charlie, the character I play, somehow for, you know, Kat Valdez represents kind of normalcy, and for someone like her, that can seem exotic and seem very attractive. So I feel like while it is sort of a kind of a outrageous premise, there is sort of a believability where you go along with the story.
Jennifer Lopez certainly knows a thing or two about marriage. She's been engaged 5 times and tied the knot with waiter Ajani Noah, singer Mark Antony and actor Chris Judd. Last year, she called off her engagement to Alex Rodriguez and is famously together again with former fiancé Ben Affleck. What are your thoughts on marriage as we speak?
My thoughts on marriage? I mean, I think they've always been the same. I believe in marriage, and I think just like Kat in the movie, Owen says, well, don't you want to wave the white flag? And she says, no, if you have, you're a math teacher, 1 in a billion trillion chance, isn't it worth it? And I think I feel the same way. They never, no, they never,
just forever, ever, 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 ever. Is it true that J-Lo crashed one of your concerts at Madison Square Garden to get that great vision?
Yeah. We didn't have that in our plans. But yeah, we did it. I had this amazing sold-out concert here at the Madison Square Garden. It was my second tour here in the States. And yeah, we thought that was a good idea to perform and do this scene for the movies. She killed it when she went out on stage. Everybody started screaming. They started singing all our songs. And it was a pretty special moment of my life and a pretty special moment for the movie.
Hey, Owen, can I ask you, what concert would you have gone to as a teenager carrying a Marry Me sign?
Well, the first concert I ever went to was the Rolling Stones.
Okay, so Mick or Keith?
Yeah, maybe Marry Me Keith. I always loved Blondie. I always thought she was really cool. I never saw her in concert, but great style and just cool.
That was crazy.
Kat Valdez left the guy from the concert, then also married her Uber driver.
I did think of you when I saw Kat watching the late night show hosts making jokes and that sort of thing. That's a bit of the real world creeping in, isn't it?
100%. I mean, there was so much about this character that I understood and that I could bring a little bit of, like, those nuances of, like, no, this is what it would really feel like. When you hear them talking, making jokes, you're like, ugh, and you want to, like, sink into the water. When you have had a heartbreak and such a public humiliation, that's a totally different feeling. And they're roasting you, like, that's hard. And she knows it's her own fault, and she knows that, you know, she put herself out there. And part of it is that. It's disappointing and it's hurtful for a myriad of reasons. And to be able to bring that and show that, I thought was interesting in this movie.
Yeah, for sure. Do you ever say anything to them the next time you're on the show?
You know what? There's been times in my life where I might have said one or two things to somebody who was especially cruel or insensitive. But to tell you the truth, no, I don't. And I know that that's part of being in the public eye, is that people are going to roast you sometimes. Things are going to happen. Sometimes you're going to be made fun of, or you're not going to be given credit. That's just part of it. And you learn to live with that and navigate that when you're a person who's been in the public eye a long time. And honestly, to not take it as seriously as you do when you're younger, right? Because you grow and you realize what the real important things in life, and you realize even from school, it's like, it's not what people say, it's who you really are.
Who do you think you are, man? Some fan?
No, I'm not a fan. Just, well, I mean, I am now.
Maluma, how much of the movie did you find true to life about the way it is to be that famous?
There are a lot of things that I felt connected with the character, for sure. He makes music, he loves fashion, but the part of the cheating, you know, like, I'm not that kind of guy, you know, like, I think Bastian, he's kind of douchebag, you know, so I didn't feel that connection with Bastian.
I'm the mum of a 14-year-old. You're about to be the mum of a pair of 14-year-olds very soon. It's such a fascinating time.
Yeah.
But it can be heartbreaking at times. How are you finding it?
I know. It's a challenge for me because I'm such a an affectionate mom. And they're getting to be teenagers. Obviously, they're 13. They're going to be 14 in a few days. And they just, you know, they want to break out a little bit. They're like, no, I'm not a baby anymore. You can't hug me and kiss me all the time. You know, so that part of it is somewhat heartbreaking. They are their own people. It's definitely a transition.
Any chance we'll see you back in Oz anytime soon?
Oh, my God, I would love to. I remember having some of my best memories on tour out there, so who knows? Maybe soon, when everything gets a little bit more back to normal. Yeah.
Is this smart?
I think we left smart 6 weeks ago. I was on my way to you.